I know that the rain is coming, and we tend to say that every week in spring, but it's always a wonderful thing. We see the beauty that he has created. We see the flowers. We see the trees bloom. We hear the birds chirping in the morning as they come to life, and it's just something to give grace and just be so thankful for. And we see ourselves. We get to walk around on this earth that God has created, and we miss the beauty. So just take the moment. Take the time that we have today to just say thank you, Lord, for all that we have, because it is amazing that he's given it to us. We thank you all for coming out here. Absolutely. We just want to say welcome as always. It's always a pleasure and a blessing to see everyone's faces as they come out here this morning. And we just can't wait to be blessed by the word of God. Let us please have our minister come up so we can pray and go before him.
Hallelujah. 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 Do you love him this morning? Do you love him this morning? Do you really love him this morning? Do you love him this morning? I'm reminded of Joshua in the Old Testament. He toiled with Moses for many, many years. And at the end, when he was finally settled in his piece of land, and he set the people down, and he told them what God expected of them. And then he said, but as for me and my house, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Is that what you feel in your house today? Is that what you feel in your house today? Because truly, you're going to be tested with that. Got solid, didn't it? Truly, we're going to be tested. But God is faithful. Whatever Satan may try to throw your way, God is faithful. He will be there for you no matter what it is, no matter how long it takes. Let's bow our heads in a word of prayer this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, we allow this place to be your place this morning. We allow you, Father, to do what you do best. Father, we know that you are the creator of the heavens and the earth. Everything that's created on this earth was created by you. Father, you look down upon man, and for some reason you have blessed us so. Father, we ask that we can return that favor to you by being obedient to what you have called us to do. And Father, let us each and every one have it written on our hearts. As for me and my house, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve you, Father, till the end. No matter what happens, no matter what comes our way, we will always look to you as the one who has given us each and everything that we have. If a sickness comes, we know that you are the one that can heal us. If there are issues of relationships in our family, we know that you're the one that can deal with those relationship issues. If it's issues with money, we know that you're the one that has the cattle on a thousand hills. If it's a job, you're the one that opens the doors. Whatever it may be, we know that you're going to allow us to rise to the top as only you can. Father, we ask that you would touch each and every person that is here this morning. Meet them at their greatest need. Allow them, Father, to pour out their hearts to you, that you may truly see and allow them to grow in you, not only today, but every day of the week. Allow Sunday to be every day of the week, that we don't just lift you up on this day, that Sunday is Monday, Sunday is Tuesday, and that we show our love for you every day. And we lift you up in a very special way. Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Father, we turn this service over to you, and we allow you to bring forth your word in power and in might. Bless us so, Father, that we have the strength to go forth and encounter this next week. We pray this in Jesus' name. Everyone say amen. 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 Amen.
Bless the name of the Lord. We serve an awesome God. But I'm telling you, we also got the adversary out there. Satan is a liar. Everybody know that, right? He is a liar. I'm telling you, whenever you decide that you're going to submit your ways to the Lord, he's going to come, and especially in the last and evil days. He's coming strong. He tried to attack me this week, took my hearing, you know, because of a ear infection. But anyway, I'm just so thankful for those who pray for me, and I know I can call on the name of Jesus. Amen. Satan, you are a liar. I want to tell him, you know, tricks are for kids, silly rabbit. Sit down somewhere. You know, but I tell you, my son surprised me by coming home. And last night he said, no, I'm going to pray for you. He grabbed the oil, anointed me, touched my ear, and started praying. And my hearing is like, it's not 100%, but it's better. I felt it. See, that's what prayer will do. But it's not just the prayer. It's the faith behind that prayer. Because I'm not claiming what the devil's trying to do, okay? I am not buying what he's selling. Amen. So let me get to announcements. I'm just a little angry with him. I'm angry with that old devil. He makes me sick. So, okay, let me get to the announcement. Blood pressure screening that was last week, I believe, is going to be held today, right after service. I hope I'm right. Yes, I got that one right. Mental health counseling is today, right after service. And also the nursing home ministry today at 2 o'clock. We're going over to Lighthouse Senior Living, so feel free to join us. And then on the 23rd, there's youth choir rehearsal at 6 p.m. And then the mass choir rehearsal, and we're looking for new members, right, is Thursday at 7 p.m. Then finally, on the 25th, the grief and loss support group will be meeting from 10 to 12 p.m. So feel free to come out. That's all the announcements I have for right now. I just want to welcome our visitors. If there's anyone here for the very first time, I'd like for you to just stand up, raise your hand, because we just want to acknowledge you. Anybody? Well, give God a hand for getting you here. Praise God. Be blessed.
There's none like you. You alone are worthy of all honor and praise. There's no other name. There is none like you.
Jesus, the name.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you. Yes, he does. God is in control. Let's stand this morning. Have a word of prayer. Approach the throne of grace. He said, come boldly. Hallelujah. We can come boldly. Bring our petition before the Lord. Father, we stand in your presence. As we stand in your presence, dear God, breathe upon us, Lord. Meet the needs of your people. Bless them and keep them by your mighty power. Let us hear what you're trying to say to the church in these last and evil days, Lord. Open our ears, anoint our ears, anoint our eyes. Give us hearts to understand and see the will of God. I ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Praise God. How many believe we're living in the last days? Praise God. Really believe we're living in the last days. You know, Pastor Elliott's been telling us for years now that things not going to get any better. Have they gotten better? No, no. So we can call him a true prophet. Praise God. Because it hasn't got, and it's not going to get better. It's not going to get better. We as his people must arm ourselves with the word of God. We must arm ourselves with prayer and seeking after God. These are the end times. And I tell the Lord all the time, I said, Lord, I want to be ready when you come. Paul said, we shall be changed in a twinkling of an eye. Praise God. I want to be changed. You want to be changed? Yes, I want to be changed in a twinkling eye. Say, meet the Lord. And what they say, he's just going to call his spirit home. Said, if we don't have the spirit of God, we are not of him. But if we have the spirit of God, he's just going to say, come home, spirit. Woo, my God, and we're going to be all gone. I'm looking forward to that day. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. As they say, walk in Jerusalem just like John. Glory to God. The most important thing in life is what? Solomon told us, serve the Lord. Yes, serve the Lord. That's the most important thing in life
is serving God, doing his will. So as I was praying, as I always do, and I'm sure all the ministers do this, you pray, you say, Lord, what would you have me to say to the people today? What would you have me to say? And this is what he told me. He said, tell them that things are not going to get better, but they don't have to worry because I have already armed them with the power that they need, and they must learn to use it. So what am I talking about this morning? I'm speaking about the power of the Holy Spirit. The power of the Holy Spirit. You have it this morning. I have it. But you know, if you don't use it or you don't know how to use it, it doesn't do you any good. But he said, take your time, explain to them that I have already given them power. You've heard people, ministers say, nothing else he's going to do. He's done it all. So let's get to it this morning. And let's hear what the Lord is saying to us. The first mention of the Holy Spirit, turn with me to Genesis 1, first chapter, first couple of verses there. The first mention of the Holy Spirit. It says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God, the first mention of the Spirit is right here. The Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. The Spirit of God is associated with power. You know you have power this morning? And Sister Ruth was talking about, I like the way your son took charge of the devil. You have power. I have power. He doesn't have to rule over us. We have power, but we have to use it. The Holy Spirit is co-equal with God the Father, and co-equal with the Son. The Trinity, that's where we get the Trinity. He's the third person of the Trinity, and you look in the Greek and the Hebrew, it talks about power being dunamis. Dunamis calls it dunamis power. Dunamis power. Power is able, where we get the English word dynamite. Do you know you walk around with dynamite? You walk around with dynamite in your power, in your hand, pull it out. He said, tell them they're going to have to use what I've given them. You have dynamite, dunamis power. Yes, my main focus this morning is going to be on how this power that we have functions in the lives of believers. I have about 7 points. Yes, we need to know how this power is working and how we can use it. You know, you have power, you have to get instructions. This is a handgun. It can do certain things, but you have to go and take some lessons and learn how to use it. You have to learn how to let the Holy Spirit work through you, in you, and for you. Praise God. In Acts 1 and 8, let's read that. Acts 1 and 8, it says, Acts 1 and 8, he's the third person, the function of the Father's life, blah, blah, blah. I want to back up a little bit. Acts 1 and 8, he gives us power. That Acts 1 and 8 say, he gives us power to do what? To witness. He doesn't just give us power to have power, but he gives you power to witness. And how do we witness? We witness verbally, and we witness by the way we live. We witness by the way we live. We witness by the way we live. I remember many years ago, Pastor Elliot used to go out and give out tracts. I said, where are you going? I'm going to witness. I'm going to put out tracts about Jesus. Going out to witness. Your life you live. The Bible says, no man lives unto himself. You're not living unto yourself. Somebody's watching you. And when they look at us, what should they be seeing? They should see Jesus, which is love. And I love it when people come to this church, they say, I feel the love of Jesus. I know he's here because I feel his love. I said, these are some of the most loving people I ever met. Love. The world should see love. The world should see forgiveness. That's what the world should see. Forgiveness. Some people wouldn't forgive you if you paid them. Is it true? But when the world looks at us, they should see forgiveness. No matter what you've done, Jeremiah says, he doesn't ever remember it again. Once you, 1 John 1 and 9, once you have asked for forgiveness, he doesn't even remember it. Now, man might remember it, but then you're not living for man, are you? I know I'm not. I'm not living for a man. I'm living for Almighty God. They should see, the world should see, they should know we are Christians by our love, by our compassion. By our compassion for one another. They should know. And the fruit of the Spirit and the day and time in which we live, there's not much joy in the world. Satan has taken it out. Mental illness has gone up. My daughter's here today. Isn't that right, Stacy? Yeah. Raise your hand. You see what she did? She went. But she works in this. That's her profession. It has gone up, mental illness. People are sad. We should have joy. We should have joy. We should have joy. Nehemiah said, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Yes. We used to say many years ago, if you don't have joy, leap for joy. And you would see people just leaping. He said, leap for joy. We should have joy, saints of God. When people see you joyful, they want to know why you're so joyful when everything, all the prices are going up, food is going up, gas going up, everything's going up. But remember, he said, I, the living God, I will supply all of your needs. Didn't he say it? He said, I will supply all of your needs according to what? Rich, is it your riches or his? That's what he said. He said, I'll supply all of your needs. That's what he said. I'll do it. He said, I'll open the windows of heaven. Woo! Come on. He said, I will do it. And I will pour you out blessings. Praise God Almighty. Woo! Hallelujah. They should see joy in us. Joy, joy. They should see joy. Another thing they should see in us is peace. Do you have peace this morning? We used to say, I got peace like a river. I got peace like a river. I got peace like a river in my soul. You have peace this morning? He said, it'll be so much peace, it passeth understanding. Man will look at you like, why you have so much peace? Why are you not troubled? Why are you not worried? Because you're trusting in the Almighty God. Hallelujah. I say you're trusting in the Almighty God. He said, I own all the cattle on 1,000 hills. He said, all The silver and gold belongs to me. He said, if I'm for you, I'm more than a... Come on. Woo! He said, no weapon formed against you. Ha! Every tongue healing, every problem, every whatever. He said, I'll bring it down. He said, I'm not gonna stop the devil now. Come on. You're right. He's not going to stop the devil. He said, but when the devil comes in, he said, I'll raise up a standard. Don't tell me he won't do it. Hallelujah. Don't tell me he won't do it. He will do it. He'll keep his word. Yes, he will. But that's what the world should see. That's how we witness. Sometimes we don't have to say a word. Praise God. That's how we witness. He promised also, he said, in John 14, 16, he says, I'll be a comforter. Jesus, he's getting ready to go back at this time to heaven, to the cross, and he's dying, going to go back to heaven. So he's talking to his disciples. He said, I will pray the Father. That's John 14:16. He said, and he shall give you another comforter. Now, he had been with them. They could go to him anytime, no matter what the problem. There he was right there. But he said, I'm getting ready to leave now. He said, but don't worry. I'm going to send you another one. And this one, glory to God, he's going to walk beside you. He's going to be in you. Whatever you need and what the problem, he said, you can just go to him and he'll be there for you. He said, I'm going to pray the Father. I'll comfort you. And he says, and his Holy Spirit also in Romans 8:14, he says, I will lead you. For as many as led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. God will lead us. We don't have to worry. God will lead us. He'll lead you. He'll direct you. I remember my mother, a great woman of God. Great woman of God. Let me tell you, she raised us in the Lord. And some people came by teaching another doctrine in our town. And my mother was so eager to know God. She said, well, maybe we should go and follow these people. She didn't know. She just knew she wanted to do the right thing. So she got up. She said, children, we're going to do this and we're going to do that because this is what they say we should do. But I'm going to show you how God works and how he leads us. Into all truth, he said, I lead you into truth. My mother went to sleep, and the Holy Spirit came to her and said, Floretta, that's my mother's name, you are on the wrong road. Don't tell me God won't lead. Don't tell me God won't direct. Yes, he will. She got up and she said, I won't say what she called us, but she said, look, children, I want to tell you something. God visited me, and he told me we were on the wrong road. She said, starting next week, we're going back and worship the way we used to worship. And it was the right thing to do. But I'm telling you this because the Holy Spirit directs and he leads. If we will only listen to him. If we will only listen to him, listen to the Holy Spirit, because he wants to guide you. Now, I'm going to tell, this is sort of personal, but I'm going to tell it that might bless somebody, might help somebody. I've tried every form of calcium that you can think of that would upset my stomach, and I couldn't find it. I've talked to homeopathic people that are supposed to know all about the body and the herbs and I could not find a liquid solid. No, I could not do it. I couldn't find it. And I said, Lord, now you know I need calcium. I'm supposed to have more at this age. And do you know how he led me? I was asleep, and he visited me. And I used to, in the morning, I would put out one glass of almond milk, the one without sugar, and I would drink it. And do you know what happened? Another one appeared beside it in my dream. And it said, no longer drink one, drink two. And two gave me almost 1,000. I said, well, I'm very close to what I should get. I said, well, I didn't think of that. But you know what? He reminds us and he leads us. Somebody said, well, that's real. That was important to me. That was important to me. Yes, as you get older, your bones need more calcium. And I said, Lord, I'm concerned about it. And you know what? That's where we live every day. You know, Pastor Elliott said years ago, he said, if you can't tie your shoe, God is interested in helping you tie it. Woo! Yes, he is. He's interested in helping you. And do you know what? I started drinking too. Not that I liked it that much, but I did it because I said I'm getting almost 1,000 milligrams of calcium. God will lead you. He will lead you. He will lead you. He's called a paraclete, one that walks beside the believer. Everywhere you go, there you know the Holy Spirit is there beside you. Mother, father, sister, brother might forsake you, friends, but the Holy Spirit is always there. He's so unjudgmental. He's there just to help you. He's there just to protect you. I think I told this story, but it's so make the point, I shall tell it again. Thank you, Sister Bird. You sound like my mother. My mother would say, sing it. Let me tell you, I could read a story from the Bible, and that's good. That's wonderful. But I'm going to tell you how God watches over his children. From my own life, we were in Delaware, and I had a chihuahua. If you know anything about a chihuahua, he will bark, 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 and he's bad, bad, bad. But I loved him. But you know what? One day I was out in the neighborhood in Delaware walking, nothing but houses. Nothing but houses. And somebody in that neighborhood didn't want me there. And they came out with their big dog and sick the dog on me. Yes, they did. Said, get him. And the dog, I looked, and the dog, that big dog was coming for me and my little chihuahua. I didn't know, was nobody around. Oh, nothing but houses. I didn't know what to do. I really didn't know. I'm like, what should I do? I ran up on the porch of another house, and there was a chair. I grabbed that little teeny dog. I wrapped him in my arms, and I held my head down, and I scooted down on the floor. That's what I did. Say, why did I do it? I don't know. It was, you know, the spirit of the moment. And I didn't look. I just held my head down. I didn't want to see him jumping on me, this big dog. If he was going to jump on me, I wasn't going to watch it. I scooped down on the floor, and I sat there, and my chihuahua, it was a miracle. He never barked. If you know anything about chihuahuas, they're bad little boys. They're girls, too. But you know why? He never settled. My dog never moved. I went, wow. After a while, I sat there for a while. I eased my eyes around, and I looked, and the dog was gone. The dog was gone. You know, I believe he probably saw an angel. I'm telling you, God can do, he's sovereign. He can do anything. I got up. I said, let me get home as fast as I can. I looked for the man. I looked for the dog. I didn't see him. They were gone. Well, see, God works. He can work. I can't even get it out. We put limits on God. We put limits on God. God is in control. We want to hear another story that is unbelievable. It's the truth. I was sitting in a restaurant, and a young man that was taking care of the food, he was fitting bagels. He has to keep flipping them with the hot fire. And I'm sitting there waiting for my sandwich. And he knows me. I know his mother. I know his family. He's an alcoholic. His mother said he's an alcoholic. He was an alcoholic, couldn't stop drinking liquor. He wasn't a Christian. His grandmother was a Christian. His mother was a Christian. But he wasn't. He was a drunk. They tell me they were getting ready to fire him because they thought he would burn himself. I walked in, I sat there in the baker shop, and I sat there, and he says, "Hi, Sister Elliot." I said, "Hi." Called his name. Do you know he went home and he told his grandmother? His grandmother told me, said, "Grandma, Sister Elliot came in and she turned into an angel." And this was an unbelieving man. He wasn't, he said, when I looked at her, she was an angel. He never took another drop of liquor. So don't tell me God can't do it. Don't tell me God can't do it. God can do anything he wants to do. He's a sovereign God. He's in control. He is our helper. Yes, he is. David said, "I lift up my eyes to the hills." You know the scripture. "Whence cometh my help?" My help comes from God. Here's David saying he's king now. He wrote this when he was king. Now, why is he saying he looked to the hills? Well, you're the king. This is my belief. I believe he was saying, "I look to the hills," because he remembered when he was a shepherd boy. He remembered when he was a shepherd boy. And what happened? The lion, the bear, all the animals came. And what happened? His spirit of God. He remembered, that's where I met the Spirit of God. That's where I met the miracle working power of God. When I was in that mountain with those sheep, I met God there. Praise God. Where do you go to meet God? Yes. Wait, do you know you can go in your prayer closet and you can meet God in there? How many know you can go in your prayer closet and you can meet God? Who want to meet God? You can meet him there. Yes, he can. And you know what? He'll be waiting for you too. And then, well, you know what? In my prayer closet, I have paper and pencil. I have holy oil. I have water. Because I know God's going to speak to me at some point. He's going to tell me what he wants me to do. He's going to tell me how to do it. He's going to tell me when to do it. And I want to get every bit of it down on pencil and paper. Because I want to do exactly what he tells me to do. God will speak to you. You have to give him time. You have to give him time. Yes, you have to give him time. He's not in a hurry. You can't be in a hurry. God teaches us. Yes, he does. He teaches us. He reminds us the purpose. The purpose of our lives is to, Solomon said, is to serve God. God has a way of teaching his children. His ways are not ours. If you claim the name of Jesus, he's going to teach you. God is going to teach you. Yes, he's going to teach me. And what's he going to teach me? How to be like him. That's what he's going to teach. He's going to teach me how to be like him. Now, I have something that I want to read to you. It blessed my heart. Mr. King gave me this. I don't know where he got it from. But it's good. How God teaches. A man once said, "I prayed for strength And God gave me difficulties to make me strong. That's how God teaches. God teaches like that. He puts you in the fire. Yes, he does. He'll put you in the fire. Yes, he will, but he'll get in there with you. He'll get in the fire with you. He won't leave you alone. And it goes on to say, I prayed for wisdom, and God gave me problems to solve. Be careful when you pray for wisdom. You're going to get some problems because he's going to teach you how to do it, when to do it. Yes, he is. He's going to teach you. You weren't going to be used of God. He's not going to use you until he teaches you something. I don't mean nothing that comes out of the books. He's got to teach you who he is. You have to see who he is. You have to desire to be like him. You have to open your heart to him. He's not going to force you. No, we have free will. Praise God. He said, I prayed for courage. God gave me dangers to overcome. Oh, my God. He's teaching us. Yes, lastly, I prayed for love, and God gave me people to help. Does he send people to you to help? All the time. All the time they send people to you to help. You're learning true love. Yes. Lastly, he convicts of sin. This lady told me, she said, I was living in sin. I said, well, God, sin doesn't bother God. God has a cure for that. He said, 1 John 1:9, confess it, turn from it. Like he met the woman at the well. He said, I don't condemn you, but don't go keep doing it. He says, if you say you have no sin, you know, some people puff themselves up. I see everybody else sins but mine. He said in John 1:8, he said, if you say you have no sin, what'd he say? You deceive yourself. We all have sinned. Sister Ellie, you sinned. Yes, I have sinned. I've come short. I was born in sin. You know, there's sin of commission, there's sin of omission. Some things you're supposed to do, you don't do, could be a sin. But I tell you again and again, God doesn't have a problem with sin. Yeah. He said, confess it. Turn from it. We're saved by Jesus Christ's stripes and believe on him. One lady came to me and I shared it. She said, good Christian woman. She said, I've been drinking alcohol for years and drinking and drinking. She said, I've been drinking liquor. I've been going to church. But she said, one day, the Holy Spirit moved on her. She said, I haven't had a drink since. Yeah, I tell people, come to church with all your sins. Come. Bring your sins. Come on to church. This is a hospital. It's a spiritual hospital. Hallelujah. We know who to take you to. We know how to take you. Take you to Jesus. We all were sinners. You know that? We all were sinners. And we all come short. Where nobody has a reason to boast. But we all depend on the grace of God. And what did God say? He said, I'm plenteous in mercy. I'm plenteous in grace. I have plenty of it. Just come to me. Woo! My God. I'm plenteous in it. My Jesus, my Jesus. And he said, when you come, he said, I won't even ever remember it again. He convicts of sin. Praise God. Yes, we trust God. He gives gifts. Do you know, I'm not going to read it, it's too long. But you know, 1 Corinthians chapter 12 from 7 to, the Holy Spirit gives gifts. You know, If God gives you a gift, use it for His glory. Use it for His glory. Don't boast. Please don't boast. Don't seek man's praise. He said, if you do, you already have your reward. You're not getting nothing from God. You're not getting anything from God. But he said, but if you do it, and I will reward you. God give gifts. You have a gift to sing. You have a gift for playing an instrument. Do it to God's glory, not to be seen. God sees. He said, I look at the heart. I try to. You know God's going to try your heart. He is. He's going to try your heart because He knows what you made up. You don't know what you made up. When He finished with you, you're going to know what you made up. Yes, you are. You're going to fall at His feet and you're going to say, Lord, give me some of that grace. Give me some of that mercy. That's what I need. Lastly, as we talk about the Spirit, in these last days, you're going to have a lot of people saying this is God and that's God. The Spirit is telling me this and the Spirit is telling me that. Oh, you better be careful. I'm going to give you two rules to go by this morning, how you can tell the truth from a half-truth, from a lie to a total lie. 1 John 4:1, it says, test, try. You notice he says spirits, plural, because you have your own spirit to deal with. You have God's spirit and you have Satan. And if Satan has his way, he's going to try his best to deceive you. Yes, he is, but don't have to worry about that. Test the spirit. Now, Pastor Elliot, he has told us for years, how to test the spirit. Number one, Pastor Elliot. So if you disagree with him, me, get him. But he's right. He's right. The word of God. Always go to the word of God. One lady said, she told this man, and I give you this little simple example. She said, that you my husband. He said, what? I already have a wife. Now you see, that's against the word of God. That's right. I said, well, it's a simple one, but it's the word of God. You understand it. You go to the word of God. You go to the word of God. This is one that so many people do miss. They miss this one here. Test who gets the glory. Test, don't go by the words. I give God the glory. No, can't go by the words. Listen to how many times they say, I, that pronoun. You know that pronoun, I. I'm giving that's a sign. They're taking the glory for themselves. Or they sharing the glory with God. He said, I will not share my glory. I will not share my glory. All of it must go to God. All of it must go to God. It's for His glory, for His praise, and that people might know that He's God. So remember that, the word of God, listen for that pronoun, listen for that pronoun, because it's about the person. They say, I'm giving glory to God, but I'm taking a little bit of His glory. That's a bad sign. Test the spirit. He said, test it. And as never before, saints, and I'm closing. My sister Genesis is coming to sing. Praise God. Test the spirit. This is the time that we live in. You have to test. You have to test. Because some people come, God said this and God said that, making them feel that they're important. Oh, stinking flesh, dirt. But test the spirit, saints. Test the spirit. I will say the benediction. She's going to sing for us. Go ahead. Oh, you have one. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He's worthy of praise. Glory to God. Like everyone to stand. Hallelujah. I'm going to pray the prayer of faith this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The centurion said, you don't have to come to my house. You don't have to lay hands on me. Just speak the word. I'm going to pray the prayer of faith. Hallelujah. Whatever your needs are this morning, you need help with your health. You need a financial blessing. No matter what you need, you've heard, God is concerned. God is concerned. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand in your presence. Hallelujah. We stand in the presence of the living God. Breathe on your people, Lord. Meet every need, Lord God. Heal, save, deliver, set free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We bind the works of the enemy, Lord. Come to steal, kill, and destroy. We bind him in the name of Jesus. We bind him in the name of Jesus. We bind him in the name of Jesus. Now, Lord, go with your people, Father. Keep them in your care. Let the name of the Lord be exalted. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.